A very quick note before this video starts, if you enjoy mobile games as much as I do, then consider watching the first episode of the brand new monthly mobile gaming podcast that I recorded with Tiny Little Games. You can find the podcast right here on my channel, and with that little promo out of the way, I'll let you get back to today's video. What is going on, folks? It's NimbleThor here, and thank you very much for tuning back into my mobile gaming quest, where today we are going to check out After Burner Climax, which is the newest game in Sega Forever collection of old school Sega games released on mobile with just an absolute ton of advertisements, and then, you know, a $2 in-app purchase to remove those advertisements. So before you go ahead and download this game, the download links are in the description box down below, by the way, please listen to my warning, you're not going to have a good time with this game unless you consider it a premium game and you're ready to buy that $2 in-app purchase to remove the advertisements. And no, it's not offline playable, so there's no way around it. You have to buy that in-app purchase if you want to play this game. But alright, with that out of the way, let's get into this arcade-style, crazy fast-flying shooter. It's an insane game, just you guys wait and see. Alright, so Boundless Ocean is the first of 20 levels that we have to get through without dying. I think we have around 3 lives, if I remember correctly. And look at this, we're already seeing enemies, and they're trying to attack us. And so the way we control this crazy game here is with a left side joystick that we use to maneuver our flight. And then we have a throttle over here on the right side that we can use to speed up or speed down. It gets really difficult if we speed all the way up. But look at this, we downed how many? 44% of the enemies, which is not too shabby. It is really, really difficult because of how fast we're flying to shoot down all of the enemies. But at the same time, it doesn't really matter if we shoot all of them. We just have to survive and get to the next level. That's at least my mission when I play these games. So now we're getting to Spring Mountains instead. Oh, I can't do this. Oh, we died. No, we lost. We lost one life. Guys, we lost one life out of 3. We have to slow down a bit. This is going way, way, way too fast. Over here on the right side, we have a couple of different buttons. The first one is for a machine gun, like this one here. And the second one is for firing missiles. I don't know why you would be using the machine gun, because it's really not that great. And the missiles are just far superior to the machine gun. So definitely make sure to use the missiles. Not the machine. Oh, whoa. Did you guys see that? Not the machine gun. We may have to speed up a tiny bit here. I feel like it's going too slow now, and it's becoming really difficult to avoid. To avoid all the missiles coming right at us. But we are seeing advertisements every 15 to 20 seconds or so. Every time we finish one stage, there's an advertisement that, of course, I've just edited out, which is why the video might feel a bit clunky. It might feel like we're jumping a bit. That's because we have to edit out all of these video advertisements. They are super frustrating, as I told you guys. So consider this a premium game. Buy that $2 in-app purchase. I'm not even gonna talk too much more about that. Just remember to do that, or you're gonna have a really, really bad time. And if you don't trust me, then just look into the review section on Google Play. There's so many people complaining about the insane amount of advertisements. And yes, we're back here at the menu because we died in the arcade mode super, super quickly. So this time around, let's head into the score attack mode instead, where I think we have infinite lives and it's just a matter of scoring the highest score possible. And so that means that we're pretty much promised to be able to get through all of the 20 different levels. Which sort of skin do we want for this plane here? I really love this one, which is the one I used before, but I guess this one here looks kind of cool as well. We can also use all of these other planes here. There are 4 planes in total. But if we want to use the other ones, we do have to watch an advertisement, which I'm not interested in doing right now. There are plenty of advertisements in this game as it is already. So let's head out for another run here. I love this intro cutscene. It looks so great. Sega definitely knows how to make high-quality games. There are way too many advertisements, but if you buy the $2 in-app purchase, you won't see those. And this is certainly a very, very high-quality game. Sega knows how to make great games. This is one of them. It is insanely difficult, but that's part of the fun as well, is that things just go so blazingly fast that you barely have time to see anything. Some might call it too hectic. I call it freaky awesome, and I'm loving it. Oh, and before I forget to mention this completely, no, this game is not completely free roaming. We are flying forward automatically, and we can't simply turn 180 degrees around and go the other direction. We are somewhat limited in where we can fly, and you can see that in some of the levels very clearly, especially the ones in the desert, where we have mountains that we have to avoid. But the same thing sadly applies to the other levels. They seem very open, but they aren't that open, and they're actually quite restrictive in where we can fly. But that's just part of the game, though. That is part of how this gameplay experience is. And I don't really see how they could give us more freedom without then also having to give up on the super fast speed of these planes here, which at the end of the day is the reason why you want to play the game in the first place. Now, the good news, of course, is that you barely notice that these levels are somewhat limiting. It took me some time to even realize that I'm not completely free roaming, just because I spent all my attention making sure that we didn't die, which is honestly a feat in and of itself in this game. So guys, what do you think about this game? Let me know down in the comment section down below. And now it's time for the mobile gaming news of the day, which is that Roblox now has 90 million monthly active users, which is really insane, considering that it's a multiplayer sandbox title that relies on users creating gameplay experiences for other users. While I'm not really in the target audience for Roblox, at least I like to think that I'm not, I can't help but admire what this company and this game has been able to accomplish in a very short period of time. It's certainly not every day that we hear about a game with 90 million monthly active users. For reference, by the way, it's the same type of numbers that Minecraft are pulling these days. 90 million monthly active users is a lot of users. So are you one of those 90 million monthly active users, or have you been in the past? And if so, what do you think about it? Let's discuss in the comments, and until next time, just keep gaming, stay awesome, and I'll see you guys around.